Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about pseudo classes in CSS. So let's get started. Before you reach the end of this video, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe so that we together can challenge and defeat the mighty YouTube algorithm. Think of a pseudo class as a special keyword that is used to define a special state of an element. And for example, I have the hover pseudo class right here. We can do things like change the appearance of a button when we hover over it. We can create drop-down menus to appear. I'll probably make a separate video on drop-down menus. We can even style certain items in a list or grouping based on certain criteria using a pseudo class. So this video is meant to introduce how to use pseudo classes. We won't cover all the pseudo classes that are out there, but at least a few of the more useful ones. And if you ever encounter a pseudo class that you might find useful for your own projects, well, at least you know how to use them. So let's begin by creating some sample text on our HTML document. We're going to create three things: a link, a button, and a list. Let's get started. Let's first create a link. So I'm just going to use an a tag, and we're going to use the href attribute, and let's set this equal to maybe Google, https://www.google.com. All right, then let's add the text for the link, www.google.com, and then let's close this a tag. Let's save, reload the page. Okay, that works for our link here. Now let's create maybe two line breaks, just to give us some space. Then let's create a button. So button type equals button. And then let's add some text to this button. Click me. And then close the button. Let's save, reload the page. There's our button. Now let's create a list. But I'm just going to separate a few of these things. Let's make an unordered list, so use the UL tag. Then let's add maybe 10 list items. So this is item number one, and let's close this. And then I'm just going to copy and paste this a bunch of times. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That should be fine. And let's close this UL tag, and I'm just going to change some of the numbers. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Let's save, reload. Okay, this is fine. Let's go to our style sheet, and let's get rid of that. Now, by default with links, the color, the text color is blue for a hyperlink, but if you've already visited that page, it's going to be purple, and you can see right now that it's purple. So you can actually delete your browser history to get rid of that, and it will go back to being that blue color for the hyperlink. Since I already clicked on this, it's already purple. So I'm just going to delete my history real quick. Well, welcome back. Now with this link, it is now blue. That is the default for hyperlinks, but it might be something different if you're using a different web browser. IDK though. So we can actually use a pseudo class to change the appearance of this hyperlink. So what we want to do is target all A elements, then colon, and then we can pick a pseudo class. So we can use the link pseudo class to change the appearance of a hyperlink. So let's change the color, and I have a hexadecimal color picker here, and we can just pick a different color. So maybe I'll pick like a seafoam green of some sort. That works for me. So I'm just going to copy this hex value and place it right here. Let's save this, then reload the page. And now what you see here is that all hyperlinks are now this seafoam green color, which is pretty sweet. That is the link pseudo class. Let's discuss the visited pseudo class. These CSS properties that are listed will apply to any link that's already visited. All right, so let's actually click on this link, then head back. It's back to that basic purple, right? So now we can actually add some CSS properties for any link that is already visited. So let's maybe change the color. And I will pick like a purplish color. And I'll take this value and then just paste it. Let's save, reload the page. Now it's like a pinkish purple color, which is a little more artistic, I would say. Okay, let's style this button. So we're going to target our button. Then we'll use the hover pseudo class. We can change the appearance of this button whenever we move our cursor over it. So let's change the color as well. So we're going to change the background dash color. And I think I will pick a reddish color. That should be fine. So I'm going to copy this, paste it, and I believe I will change the text color as well. And I will just pick white. Okay, so let's save it, reload the page. So there doesn't appear to be any changes to our button, right? But if we take our cursor and hover over this button, that's when these CSS properties will kick in whenever we hover over an HTML element that is listed. So this doesn't really appear to do anything when you click on it. It does become focusable where there's this blue border around this, but we can actually change the appearance of this button when we click on it. So we're going to use the active pseudo class. So let's target our button element, and we're going to use the active pseudo class. And I guess I'll just change the background color again. And I will pick a slightly darker shade of red. That should be fine. And let's paste that, save, let's reload. And now when we click on this button, you can see that it just flashed really dark, right? So the active pseudo class is applied whenever you click on something or you hold something down. So you can see that it's that darker shade of red now. It's kind of like it's a 3D effect where we're pushing in the button and it's not getting as much sunlight where it's kind of like in the shade then, you know what I mean? So the active pseudo class applies to any HTML element that is clicked or is held down. All right, moving on. I have a few pseudo classes that are useful for different list items or groupings of items. And the first one that we're going to discuss is the first child pseudo class. So we have a unordered list here and we have 10 list items. We can actually target specific list items and then give them some CSS properties. So I'm just going to type in li and then we're going to use the first dash child pseudo class. And this is going to apply to the first list item in some sort of list or grouping. So maybe I'll change the background color. I should really discuss more CSS properties too, but colors are kind of fun to work with. And maybe let's pick like maybe a greenish color. I already picked one out already, so I'm just going to use this one because it was a pretty sweet color. So a 93FF7D. All right, so this first child pseudo class will apply to the first item in some sort of list or grouping. So let's reload the page. Now this list item is now highlighted. Now there's another pseudo class that is the last dash child, and this will apply to the last element in some sort of list. So I'm just going to copy this background color and paste it. And this color will now be applied to the last item in your list. And actually, if we were to add one more item to this list, this would actually change. So currently, list item number 10 is highlighted, right? So let's save this, reload. Now we have a new item within our list, and the last child pseudo class now applies to, well, the last item now, which is now item number 11. I do have a few other pseudo classes related to lists I'd like to show you guys, so I'm just going to comment this out for now, the first child as well as the last child pseudo class. All right, this next one is called the nth-child pseudo class, but we're going to add a set of parentheses right after and then a set of curly braces like we normally do. Now, we can target a specific item within some sort of grouping by putting the item number within the parentheses. Let's say that we want to target maybe this fifth item right here. We're going to put the number 5, all right? And then I'll just copy what we had here before with the background color. So let's save, reload. Now the fifth item in this list or grouping is now highlighted, or it has this CSS property applied to it. Now if we were to change this number to maybe 3, save and reload, this now applies to the third item in our list or grouping. And before we finish this video, I'm going to show you guys a few different tricks related to the nth child pseudo class. So for now, I'm just going to move this comment a little bit down further and then save, reload. We're going to copy this and then just make one change. So we don't necessarily need to place a number here between the parentheses of the nth child pseudo class. We can also type in a word such as odd to target all odd numbered items within this list or grouping. So let's see what happens now when we put the word odd here. So all odd numbered items now have this CSS property applied to them, and we can do the same thing with even numbered items. So I'm going to paste this, change odd to even, but I'm going to change the background color so it stands out. So I'm just going to pick a slightly lighter shade of the same color. Let's copy this hex value and then place it here. So this color will be applied to all even numbered items in this list. So let's save, reload. And what ends up happening is that we get this nice looking table. It's something you might see in like a textbook for school or something. So all odd numbered items are this color. All even numbered items are this other color that's lighter. And I have one last trick for this video to show you guys. We can create a custom formula within the nth child to target very specific items within a grouping of some sort. So for now, I'm just going to turn the rest of this into a comment, and this will be the last one I'll show you guys. So we're going to type in li colon nth child, and then set of parentheses, set of curly braces. Now within the parentheses, there's a formula we can put in here. It is a n plus b. All right, so we're actually going to be replacing each of these letters with some sort of value, and here is a definition of each of these values. So I'm just going to write a comment right here. So a equals the cycle size. How many times do we want this to repeat? N is our counter, and it starts at 0. And then lastly, b is equal to our offset value. Then I should probably write this one more time right here. So that was a n plus b. Okay, I'm just going to save and reload. So this is all cleared then. Now let's say that we want to target every third item within our list here. So for our cycle size, we're just going to put 3 here instead of a. We can keep n here, we can keep that at 0, plus the offset. And if we don't want an offset, we'll just place 0 here. Now we can add some CSS properties. I think I'll change the background to like maybe like a highlighter yellow color. So maybe I'll use background image and a linear gradient. So linear dash gradient, and then to right. And I have two colors picked out already. So that was FFF421. This is yellow, and 6Fs, which is just all white then. So this is like a highlighter effect of some sort, but make sure you spell background right, because I didn't. Okay, so this CSS property is going to apply to every third item in our group. So let's test it out then, just to prove I'm not a liar. So let's save, reload. Now each third item in this group has this CSS property applied to it. Now we can actually add an offset to this. So for example, if I were to add 1 here, the offset would be 1 then. If I change this to 2, you can see that everything shifted down by 1 then. And if the offset was 3, it shifts down further. So if you want to add an offset, you could just change that here. So now if you want like every fourth item, you would just place 4 here instead of 3. So now every fourth item has that CSS property applied. Oh, and one last thing before you go. With these pseudo classes, you're not limited to only changing the colors. I was only using colors just because I think they're fairly simple to use. You can add other CSS properties as well. For example, I could also change the opacity, and maybe I'll set this to 0.5 for 50%. Maybe I'll add a border around each of these. So border 1 pixel solid. So now we have a border around these selected items. So you can pretty much add any CSS property that you want to these pseudo classes. I was only using colors because they're pretty simple to use and, well, they're kind of pretty. So that's the basics of pseudo classes. If you would like a copy of this markup, I'll post this in the comments down below. There's still more pseudo classes out there. These are a few of the more basic ones that you might encounter. They're fairly useful. If there's any new pseudo class that you encounter, you at least know how to add it and use it then. But yeah, those are the basics of pseudo classes in CSS. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.